Silverthorne off the boards, gets the break, goes with it. Silverthorne puts it onto the back post.
Oh,
puts it into the back post. And it goes forward from Macaulay Hayward. He's having the right hand over the top. Driving it in. And Miller's going toe to toe. And he's got three or four headshots. And then drags it down. Still has it. Szabo being sort of marked out of the game by Tom. And the shot comes from Trump forward. Now, Mabrea with plants. Mabrea walks in, shoots.
And he looks up his own rebound and scores.
Szabo. And he's not happy about that. It was a late hit to hit from behind. And you see the players. Good evening and welcome to Icing Tonight on Made in Birmingham. The Telford Tigers have a midweek game tonight against the Hull Pirates. But first, let's take a look at last week's action when the Tigers took on the Peterborough Phantoms. Now we look in for the first period. The Telford Tigers taking on the Peterborough Phantoms. Referee Matthews takes charge of the game. He was the man in charge last week when the two teams met each other. And he drops the puck for the first period. And it goes back to Sam Zajac in D. D to D pass across to Jones. And now the puck pass forward. And then intercepted by Pluskauskas. Hits the blue line, gets the first shot of the game away. It goes wide to the left of the post. Deflects off the boards up into neutral ice. The puck dropped down. Just deep in the corner now. Peter will play it behind the net. Sustas goes in, plays it down off the boards. Referee steps out. And now Padlec. Jones just shove him off his feet. As it comes up to the slot, and now McEwen's on the break down the left wing. Davis comes screaming through the middle. McEwen cuts in, passes across. Clarkson comes in for the back post. Didn't connect, and what a corking hit from young Sam Zajac. You saw Sustas driving up the right side. And Peterborough goal as they break in the other direction. Padlec drives through, gets his stick on the puck and puts it into the back of the net. I was just talking about the hit that Davis gave Padlec, Sustas, should I say, as he came up ice. It was a beautiful hit. He was slightly off balance. He hit him in the centre of the chest, took him off his feet. Peter on the break, because he's a defenceman, stepped up and made that play. It left Telford vulnerable at the back. The two players came through, and suddenly Peterborough put the puck under Sam Gospel on exactly 3 minutes and put the first goal of the night in the back of the net for the Peterborough Phantoms, going one goal up on 3 minutes.
Well, I'm afraid that's where my eyes were on Sustas. I missed the goal.
Yeah, I only glanced down and they had a couple of attempts at it. But the first goal of the night falling to Peterborough Phantoms. Phantoms fans find themselves a goal up 3 minutes in as the puck's shot down for icing. Clarkson, and he lines up with a player in front of the bench.
Padlec.
There's a little two in and fro in with Norton, and then Padlec exchanges a few words with him. And you saw Clarkson give a little bit of a forearm shove to the helmet of Norton. Slava's technique of playing that defensive trap where you've got five players causing congestion between blue to blue, stopping that structured breakout, seems to work very well so far. We've seen it before, and Telford have counteracted it.
They've got in!
Oakford shoots from the point. Plant is stood in front of the netminder, gets the screen on, whether it got a tip in, but it did the job either way. The Telford Tigers now on the clock, shot from the point, either a tip in or a screen from Rick Plant, number 17 in front. Sam Oakford was the shooter, and Telford Tigers put a goal on the clock. We're back to 1-1. Time of the goal, 7 minutes and 35 seconds.
We're just saying there, Peterborough have looked on top here, and they've had the more structured approach to the game, but that one came out of the blue. Who got it? Did Plant get a touch?
Yep.
Yes, he did.
Tip in from number 17, Rick Plant, assisted by Sam Oakford with a shot from the point and a great structured goal. Oakford got that shot away earlier from that back pass. It worked once again. The difference with that shot was Plant was in front of the netminder, stood in his way so he couldn't see the puck coming through, and then tipped his stick to the puck to change direction and put it in the back of the net. Now Peterborough getting held up, and now Clarkson puts the puck down low. Davies with the backhand pass tries to put it back around. It only gets as far as the Peterborough D-man, who plays the puck off the wall. Griffiths tries to shoot. Taylor intercepts, backhands it up to Clarkson, who knocks it on to try and find Warren Tate. Peterborough backhand it out into neutral ice from the blue line. Shot goes high. Gospel makes the catch, but the puck drops down at his feet.
Sam
Oakford
Gospel
tries to clear it out, only gets as far as Stubbley. And Stubbley picks up that rebound and shoots and scores, beating Sam Gospel to his left side. That was unfortunate for Gospel. He made the catch and mid-save. The puck dropped out of his catcher to the feet of Oakford. Oakford scooped it to clear it out. Stubbley held it in just inside the blue line, let the wrist shot go early, and and beats Gospel for the second goal of the night, 26 minutes and 50 seconds.
I don't think...
Stubbley with a wrist shot from the point, putting Peterborough a goal in front.
I've got to say it, I don't think Gospel's having the best of games tonight.
No,
to be
him had better.
He's made a couple of little errors. He's not getting much support back there, let's be fair. And to get to him, you've got to get around five other players first. But no.
Right, if you were the coach, would you change the netminder?
I would give him a few minutes to see if he can settle down. But it's such a crucial game. You know, Baston's been doing very well. It's good competition for the two of them.
Yeah.
I think probably I'd be inclined to change now.
Just on form.
Yeah.
Oh, look at the back of the puck's loose. Tate skates onto it. And it was Moore that skated backwards. I don't know whether he hit a rut or caught an edge, but he ended up tipping over backwards, left the puck, and Warren Tate came skating in. The downside for the Tigers, because he was so close to the netminder. Stefanek now on the break in the other direction. Wrist shot away.
Susters drives the left wing. Darge on the right.
Shot comes across. It was open. And he tapped it in. That was a great pass. He puts it across to the slot. Fair play to Gospel. He'd taken the angle from the shooter. The pass comes in front of him. And the winger comes in on the slot and puts his stick on the ice. The defenseman ties up with him. I think it was Danny Rose. But he got his stick to the puck. And Peterborough now go two goals up on 31 minutes and 11 seconds as it gets eerily quiet here in the Telford Ice Rink.
Eerily quiet. Eerily quiet indeed.
Owen Griffiths, I think, was the scorer. Got on that, yeah, came across the front. Beautiful skate into that slot area. Danny Rose read it well, tied up with him, but he'd still got his stick on the ice. And the pass comes across, deflects from the stick, into the back of the net. Clarkson, I thought he was trying to get on the back post. Norton intercepts once again. And I tell you what, you can't take away the defensive work from
Absolutely
the Phantoms here.
Not. It's
Weaver,
been happening all night.
Down to Davis, across to the back post.
Oh, what a cracking
goal! And that was the play. The triangle from Weaver to Davis to Clarkson. Shoots and scores with 8 seconds left on that penalty. The goal will cancel the 8 seconds, which means Telford remain on the power play for the next 45 seconds. Textbook. If that had happened 8 seconds later, they'd have lost the advantage. They've still got a man advantage now as they score with 8 seconds of the first penalty remaining. So it's the Telford Tigers now bring it back to 3-2. The
Clarkson,
goals.
Clarkson, watch this. Clarkson and Archer. He's just off. He's just said, let's go now.
Goal scored by Clarkson. Assisted by Kalina. The Susters having a bit of a battle with Zajac. They're looking at each other. Are you going to go? Aren't you going to go? Zajac with a cross check, and that was
and
a cheap one. That's going to be rough. Let's get in there.
And we've got two or
it
three.
It was Zajac that threw that. Susters is throwing a few. Zajac's putting some rights in. You can see him punching and with the uppercut. He was frustrated off the last play. He went in, cross checked him on the boards, and had a bit of a rumble with him. And you can see that Zajac undoubtedly will get the greater penalty for that incident.
Okay, the putt. Carried out by Peterborough. Off to the left side. White.
Well, he's robbed Stefanek. Of it there.
Clarkson.
Clarkson.
On the back end, by the top shelf.
Oh,
goes over. Ozin's shirt. Oh, top shelf. Over his shoulder. And Clarkson, using that long reach, pulls the puck around. Look at him, coiling it back towards the Peterborough bench as he skates in front of him and celebrates the goal that brings it back to 3-3 here at the Telford Ice Rink. Both teams are 4-on-4. We've commented countless times that Telford can get goals shorthanded. They were even-handed, but with less players out on the ice, it gives you more space and more time. Big Dougie Clarkson driving the puck, putting it on his backhand and taking it over the top of Ozin's left shoulder. 3-3 the score, Alan.
Hardest goal to score. Backhander into the top
corner. Shelf, yeah.
Absolutely wonderfully executed there by Big Dougie Clarkson.
Stretch pass out as far as Kalina. The puck bounced a little bit. It's a one-on-one. Kalina tries to pull it in top. The defenseman gives him a shove. The puck drifts into the corner. He goes and salvages that puck out of the corner. Works well. Stefanek and Oakford. Stubbley.
The Tigers have got a man advantage for 45
shot.
Seconds.
Zajac Gospel makes the save. The puck deflects into Jones. He carries it up.
Tigers gain possession. A shot from
Weaver. Shoots a deflection from Jason Silverthorne in the slot. You saw the shot come from Jonathan Weaver as it goes through the middle of the ice. Ozins has got the angle sorted. It takes a deflection from Silverthorne's skate. Not only did it change direction, it elevated up into the back of the net. And goal number 4 sees the Telford Tigers take the lead for the first time tonight on 50 minutes and 33 seconds.
Well, just as we speak about another goal would liven the game up, there we have it, folks. It's going to be a humdinger of the last 10 minutes, that's for sure.
22, Jason Silverthorne, changing the direction of the puck, sending it goalbound. And you've got to acknowledge Jonathan Weaver. That shot, hard slap shot, on the ice from the point. Punt drives puck goalbound. Hosens makes the save. Moore passes the puck out, and now a drive forward. Padleck delays, shot comes in from Sustas. The puck cleared out by Zajac, off towards Plant, forward to Silverthorne, pushes around the right side. Plant trailing in. Milan Kalina comes in on the high slot, the pass comes across, and Kalina fires it goalbound, and all of a sudden the Telford Tigers find themselves two goals in front. Time of the goal, 52 minutes and 49 seconds.
So another good result for Tom Watkins' men, cementing their place at the top of the table. Tonight, the Telford Tigers take on the Hull Pirates, and we'll have all the action after the break. Welcome back to Icing Tonight. The Tigers taking on the Hull Pirates on a midweek. Adam, enjoying your hockey at the moment?
Yeah, it's going well. We're winning games, so it's the main thing, really. Just getting wins and work out a way to a league title. So.
Absolutely. On your shifts, you seem to be adding a lot of pace to the game. And are you enjoying the teammates you're playing with at the moment?
Yeah, I mean, what I do, really, is just try and keep the tempo high, as much energy as possible. And then, yeah, just keep the team going.
So the Telford Tigers taking on the Hull Pirates tonight, a midweek game, and it's been quite a heavy schedule for Tom Watkins' men, playing in Hull last Wednesday, weekend games as well. Do you think that'll take its toll on the skaters?
It could very well do, you know, when games have been missed over the holiday period or whatever, and you've got to catch them up. It's got to be a midweek game, and it's another game in the week, and yes, it will take it out of the guys. And of course, we speak quite regularly about midweek games. You know, it's an odd night to be playing. It does have its effect.
Now, looking at the team lineups, you'd think on paper that this should be a comfortable game for Telford, but we've yet to see a really comfortable game this season, I'd have thought.
You know, we see week in, week out, anything can happen in this league. Hull have won one in the last five games. Tigers have won all of the last five games. So as you say, on paper, it should kind of be a walk in the park for the Tigers. But as I said earlier, it's a midweek game and anything can happen. Hull have travelled a long way. You know, anything can happen.
Let's take a look at the first period action. Paul Brooks is the referee taking charge of the game. He just looks down to the netminders and the goal judges to check that they're ready. Raises his arm on the first period and drops the puck. And in it goes as the Hull Pirates win the draw. D-to-D pass. And Gent just loses his footing there as he goes back. Curl up ice. Passing the puck forward. Dump deep. And Gent is the player that skates in, gets there first. Backhands it across corner to corner. Fisher locks out with Sam Oakford on the boards. The puck comes across to Weaver. Then passed up to the right wing, Rick Plant. But held in by Gent, I think it was. No. Watt on the far side. Just pushes the player. Now, Oakford steps up to the blue line. Puts the puck through to Kalina. Watt turns up ice, kicks the puck forward. Weaver.
I don't know how you say his name. Tamar. We'll call him Tamar. Tamar. He's running away with the point statistics. He's a goal machine.
Yeah.
88, Tamar. Maybe something.
Now, Taylor steps up. Cahorn's with him. Pass comes across. Oh, and the pass just went into his feet a little bit, and he couldn't get his stick on it. Tate recovers the puck and takes it back into their own end. But potentially that would have been the first golden opportunity of the night for the Tigers. Now, Cahorn passes through to Taylor. Drives down the left side. Puts the puck across, and it goes straight across the front up to the point, where Danny Rose tries to tip it down, but now a drive forward from the Hull Pirates comes back in. Thamer shoots and scores! You were just saying
goal machine
that he is the scorer, and the three players came down, moving the puck between them. Suddenly the rink drops into silence as Thamer gets himself on the score sheet at 2 minutes and 24 seconds. The scorer was 88, just waiting for the official assist, but a great breakaway there from the Hull Pirates. Picked up possession in neutral ice, drive down as a three, passed the puck across. Thamer was coming into the back post, received the pass and tipped it under John Baston to be the first goal of the night. 2 minutes, 24 seconds, and the Hull Pirates lead by a goal to nil.
And that team, our goal machine, plods on. I was just writing some notes down there. I was going to mention the Cahorn, Taylor and Tate line for the Tigers is really starting to settle down together, and then they're going to concede the goal. But yeah. Curse of the commentator again.
Drive forward there. Scored by number 88.
Puck forced in by Toner.
There's Osman at a million miles an hour, forechecking. Yeah.
Silverthorne tries to drive through the defence. Kalina picks up the puck as they hold it up well. Comes across. Salem now. Back on the puck. Backhands it down to the corner. Scissors puts the pressure on. Plant goes in there first. Scissors puts his body between.
Oh, and a bad giveaway there.
What? Picks it up. Oh, shoots on the point.
They hit the post, I think.
And that was a... I'm not sure if it was a save or a deflection from the pipe work. It's difficult to see. The puck went in quick, deflected out into the corner, and I think that gave John Baston between the pipes one of his nine lives. Puck comes forward, dumps corner to corner by Zajac. First skater in is Matty Davis.
Poor giveaway by Telford there. Well picked up on by Hull. Could have been 2-0. Very close.
Hi to Ross, who's not feeling very well, watching from the sick bed, watching the coverage. Come on, you Tigers, is Ross's message.
Well, that scoreline's not going to be helping Ross at the moment.
No, not at all.
But here we go, McEwen's Rob. Ooh, he's...
Puck just drifts
wide
off to the side. Hull, look for that stretch pass.
And it goes.
And there he is, Tamar in the high slot. Looks for the pass in front of the slot. A shove away from Bell, and now, and it's picked up by McEwen, who drives forward. Delays the puck to Davis.
And this is working it down into the corner.
Carries it down, comes across the front. Picked up now by Oakford, drops down. Danny Rose and Clarkson in the high slot. Clarkson shoots and scores. We're just saying he was hovering in the high slot. The pass comes up to him and he just sends it goal bound. And it's big Doug Clarkson that gets himself on the score clock, bringing it back to one apiece. This time the time of the goal is 4 minutes and 29 seconds. At 4:29, the goal scored by Doug Clarkson.
Well, that'll make Hubbard's making Ross feel a little bit better after going the 1-0 down there. There's some great work from Hull. They're forechecking hard, yeah. And to me, they're looking the more dangerous at the moment. But Telford have pulled it back.
Not many shots.
No.
It's all about goals tonight.
A couple of shots each.
Fisher backhands the puck around in off the boards. Oakford picks it up. Backhands it round to Rose. Across to Cahorn. Looks for the backhanded pass to come through the middle there. Toner gets in the way.
Taylor gets the shot away.
Gets a bit of a touch on it. Tate and Taylor cycle the puck in the corner. Back through to Cahorn. Sends it up high, but intercepted well by the Hull Pirates. Zajac keeps it in, gets as far as Clarkson, sends it goal-bound. Goes to the left of the post, deflects off the boards, into the corner.
Clarkson passes almost like a shot, isn't it? You know, yeah. He's such a big...
It's a rocket of a
power.
You wouldn't necessarily want to be on the receiving end sometimes.
It reminds me of Chuck Taylor back in the day. You know, yeah. He was very like that. It was hard to receive a pass from Chuck because it was so hard.
Yeah. Kalina skates in, looking for a bit of extra space. Great backhand pass to Clarkson, who shoots. And the netminder hangs up. Well, he makes the save and... Did the net come off again? No, there's a man in the crease, referee Brooks indicates to. That's Lane.
Lane, yeah, he's got an...
Up to the point,
we can see his number, but not his name.
Yeah.
Lane. Ooh, and that's a dangerous area for the...
Lane bobbles it through on the backhand, it goes into the corner. Zajac feeds it up, tries to get McEwen. Bonner gets in the way. The shot comes in once again from Tamar, the danger man, and he loses footing. Right, he appeals ref, for a penalty, looks back at referee Brooks, who calls nothing, so the game continues, but he's a real danger man. Stokes and McEwen getting pretty heavy on the old woodwork now with the stick work between the two of them in neutralised.
What's getting sloppy here is Telford coming out of their own end. There's about three or four times they've just passed it across ice and it's gone straight.
Hull are trapping up that neutralised pretty well. Peterborough did it effectively in the first period of the last game,
but they're doing it well because they're going deep, and as soon as Telford get possession, they're coming back to Telford's blue line, and that's where they're
forcing the play. Trapping it up and neutralised so they can't get those clean passes out. Kalina now on the break. Hits the blue line, pulls it inside, but one too many. Kurt read it well. Deflects the puck away from the goal. Shot comes in, this time from Silverthorne. Rebound, lunged forward towards Weaver. Weaver hangs onto the puck, finds the pass to Goodison. Lets the shot go. Pad deflection, Kalina reaches for it, but Hull now clear it out to neutralise. Weaver sticks it down. High stick, but that was fairly weak. McEwen, Zajac. Goes to the back post to Davis. The puck comes to the feet of Clarkson, but great defensive play from Lane, getting his body between Clarkson and that shooting lane. Zajac then with a wind-up shot from the blue line, shooting slightly wide to the right of the post.
What's apparent here, Paul, is the Tigers are starting to take charge in the offensive zone now. They're setting up like as if it was a power play, maintaining possession, looking for that opening. It looks more controlled.
Puck off the boards now.
And Hull are being more opportunist. They're going for Bonner. The sniper. They're going for the sniper sort of reply.
Tamar curls in behind the goal and picks the puck up in the corner. Steps up. Jones lunging forward and pushing him back to neutralise. He went back into neutralise, but he takes the puck with him and passes beautifully on the backhand through to Boothroyd. Kirk.
Held down low by Chilcott. Puts it deep into the end zone. Plant will pick it up in the corner. Plays it over to Oakford. Just taps it on to Rose. Hull deflects it back. Rose once again tries for that cross-ice pass to Plant, but Boothroyd gets in the way of that. The puck runs on to Silverthorne, sends it round the boards, into the corner. A slider skate shot, a bit of a puck running its way around the boards. Weaver looking for that angle, tries to get the shot away. Laxel, and a catchy mitt save.
Laxel covers that one up. Yeah, well, I say we had Rashke and Gould for Peterborough. That's one. That's
only in Alan's mind, 50, if you're wondering what's going on. Weaver. More. Down to Clarkson. 30 seconds on the period. Weaver fakes the shot.
Clarkson's teed up here. Yeah. There it is. Oh, he's passed it across and he's given it away.
Yeah, they intercepted it. One thing was that Hull playing that aggressive box on the shorthanded play, and they're intercepting those high passes that Telford are trying to get that first shot away. Zajac decides just to take one from the point. Goes slightly wide to the right of the post. The puck runs on. 9 seconds left in the first period action as Kalina tees up, tries to find Oakford on the back post. Zajac skates in, winds up for a shot, held on by the netminder, and at the end of the first period, it's one apiece, the Hull Pirates versus the Telford Tigers. So one goal each in a fairly even period. You saw Hull get themselves first off the mark with the first goal on 2 minutes 24 seconds. Then Telford, another couple of minutes later, answered it to even it up. And pretty much since then, there hasn't been many goal-scoring opportunities.
It's been back and forward. I think Telford are starting to play the more structured attacking game here. They're sort of getting into the Hull end and setting up more structure than Hull are doing. Hull are taking a couple of opportunities, breakaways, and they've had a couple of shots on net. But really, after those goals, there's been nothing much to report on.
So we look in on the start of the second period. Referee Brooks raises his hand, drops the puck. Hull win the draw, goes back off the draw. Still on the penalty kill for the next 10 seconds or so here at the Telford Ice Rink. 1-1 the scoreline. Weaver skates out, passes the puck off to Silverthorne on his right. Silverthorne down to the middle lane to Kalina. Backhands across to Plant, who tries to get the shot away. The puck deflects off the wall. Telford hanging on to the puck. Shoots across from Oakford. Pad save, back to 5-on-5.
I think the Tigers did start to camp out towards the end of the first period in the Hull end. Jonathan Weaver drops it for Davis, over to Clarkson, there's the shot.
Silverthorne also just tries to pick the puck up in front of the netminder and tip it goal bound.
Oakford just moving up front there, he's playing a forward role.
Yeah. Is he presumably screening the netminder or what have you on the power play?
Unless
runs on Cahorn.
Cahorn started on Dean, he's moved up forward now.
Strange. Just to open the position up, I suppose, to allow him to skate through, to stop Hull locking up the players.
Yep.
Again, you've got a bit of coaching chess going on here as the puck sent corner to corner. Zajac, Cahorn skates in. A lot of traffic behind the net.
Zajac will go for it. He's pushing along the ice, though. Kalina is looking for an angle.
Looks for quick feet. Sends a goal bound, the rebound comes down, Cahorn skates in, but then it's batted out by the netminder as we're back to 5-on-5 into the corner. Maynard now skates the puck out, looks across, he's on his own, so he takes it to the left side. Oakford angles him towards the boards, he puts the brakes on, turns back up ice, keeping possession, but now we're back to 5-on-5, and Kalina takes it over the blue line, tries to pass it through.
Cahorn!
Gets it through to Cahorn, who throws it in the back of the net. The grit and determination of Kalina just over the blue line, battling with Watt to gain possession of that puck, eventually winning that battle, getting the pass through to Cahorn, who fires it goal-bound, and it's an even-handed goal, scored at 26 minutes and 30 seconds by Cahorn, putting the Telford Tigers a goal in front. 2-1 the scoreline, Alan.
Well, they went a full 2 minutes, peppering the goalkeeper on the power play, got nothing of it, goes back to even-handed and they score a goal. That's how it is here at Telford, I'm afraid. Power play working well, but not clinical enough to finish it off.
I think the most effective in that power play was undoubtedly Hull's short-handed penalty kill.
Yeah, it was killed brilliantly.
So much traffic in front of the netminder. Telford moved the puck around well, but never got the...
puck as far as the netminder in many cases.
Jonker, where's Jonker?
Yeah. He's still very active on social networking.
Yeah, he's a good artist. You notice he writes all his stuff with a Durham accent as well.
I do, yeah.
He spells the word two, T-E-R. I'm going to tell you.
Off the wall, Gent curls up ice. Taken back across by Boothroyd, across to Maynard.
Jonker, one of the guys who was very influential in the young Tom Watkins career, you know.
Yeah, absolutely.
The early days.
And the young players of so many players whose career started in the north of England.
Well, I was nearly decapitated on more than one occasion by Jonker and his and people like Hep Tindale, old names that are still around but not playing for many years.
Gent, well, I can remember when three of his kids were on the first line out of Kingston,
Steve,
as Steve it was.
And Anthony and Sean, yeah. All brilliant players as well. And I mean, all hailing from Durham, like the Cooper brothers as well. There's some talent come out of that area. And Whitley Bay, brilliant talent come out of Whitley Bay.
And Alan Gould.
Yeah, whatever. Whatever.
Kalina and Weaver, of course. Plant.
Weaver's from
Sunderland. Yeah, but he played out of Durham.
He's from Sunderland. I can't even say it.
You can't even say it.
No, there's some good talent comes out of the northeast. As I say, the names you mentioned and
Plant holds the puck inside, and Bonner pulls it up, and Plant's had enough. He holds him round the throat, and round the neck, and he sort of got him in the old nutmeg position, as it were. But Rick just losing his rag with him then.
Yeah. Not seen Rick go. I've not seen Rick go this season. I think, but it takes a lot to get Rick right.
It really
that,
does.
It? You know what I mean? There must be somebody niggling at him.
And
well, as the song is saying, we can blame that one on the boogie, and apparently. Rick's into the box.
The player that's gone is Bonner with Plant. And he was doing something to aggravate him, and Rick just sort of held him around the throat and just sort of around the back of the neck and just warned him. I think gave him...
Yeah.
But they're both going to pick up a minor penalty. Cahorn. Carries it around the back of the net. Curls, puts the brakes on. Two hole players pin him against the wall, come out with the puck. Three of them break away from the puck. Passing forward into the middle lane. Salem reaches for it. Oakford tries to tip it away. Haywood recovers it, pushes it down into the end zone. 33 seconds, the Hull Pirates remain with a man advantage. Puck deflected off the wall.
Osmond Dumpsey, he's getting the evils from Salem there. He's kind of saying, what are you doing that for? I was waiting for the pass. A bit of disharmony shown on the ice there. Not a good thing to see.
And I think that's what we're talking about with Hull, when they made a lot of changes. There was that sort of lack of that tight bond they had as a team at the early part of the season.
And now here's a one-on-one, and here's Kalina. A two-on-one.
Shoots.
He's gone himself. Ooh, straight into the body of Lacazille. We haven't seen Marshall for a while.
No, he's at uni, I think. In Cardiff, come up with irons, I think it is. I think it's Cardiff, but he's definitely at uni, so he's not living in Telford anymore. So we see less of him. Silverthorne.
I bet his dad's saving a fortune.
Yeah. You think his old man would come up if he's got a game here and say hello, but no. Not on a school night, eh, Rich? Up to Weaver. Across to Clarkson. Shot! Bad save! Kept in by Clarkson, dropped onto one knee.
Look at Clarkson teed up. He's gone for that wide angle shot again. He's waiting for it.
Davis. Shoots! Rebound comes down. McEwen struggling for it. Silverthorne goes. And the netminder covers the puck up and gives us a stoppage of play. Alan can't talk now because he's got a mouthful of some poor fans' chips.
It's Mrs. Chris Monk. And I think this is Chris's sister. She didn't want the chips or arguing about what to do with them. I said, I'll put them here, Ali.
Give them to Al.
I'll get told off now because somebody will have heard me that I've got more chips.
Shot comes across. Well, it's Chris's fault for not being here to share them, isn't it? Now, puck deflects off the glass, up and over to Danny Rose, forward to Rick Plant, deflects off the backhand, Haywood skates it through, nudges it onto Tamar, winds up with a rocket of a shot into the body of Baston, then there's a bit of pushing and shoving in the slot. Tate dumps the puck around the boards, goes behind the net, up into the corner, Tamar puts it down low, Bonner looks to pick it up behind the net and pass it forward. Now, Silverthorne. Backhands it back to O'Flaherty, puts it in on the backhand, skating from Tate. Stokes gets to the puck first. Tate pins him against the wall. O'Flaherty's in there as well, trying to dig the puck out. 2 minutes remaining in the second period.
Face off in the Tigers zone.
Hull just having a little bit of a team talk there with Kirk and Chilcutt and Watt. Just talking about what they're going to try and do in these last 57 seconds. Maybe a little strategy to try and get themselves a goal back. It'd be great for them to go in the dressing room, evening things up.
That's the ideal situation. And it's free, and Baston Mando.
Oh, what comes in, and the rebound comes in. Salem picks it up and tips it home. And what you got there is determination, because they didn't win the draw. You got what puts the pressure on. Salem's on the back post. They got the first shot away. Baston makes the save. He gave up a rebound, and Salem was there to take it and capitalise and put it on the back of the net. And what did I say? At 39 minutes and 8 seconds, Nathan Salem was the scorer, assisted by Watt, timed at 39.08, bringing it back to a tied game, 2-2 as we head towards the break. 42 seconds left in this second period.
Yeah, exactly right. It was teed up from the face off. The instructions were given to a full activity.
There's a pit, 24 degrees with his bottle of beer.
And I'm about minus 3 degrees with my bag of chips.
Somebody else's bag of chips, Alan. Yeah. Get this right.
What? I said I was giving them. Sorry, I was just looking at the picture that the Chris has sent over. Very nice.
23 seconds. Puck comes through to middle. Centre ice. Puck's loose. Silverthorne on to Kalina. Shoots. Pad save. Rebound deflected by Salem into the corner. Kalina goes in. Throws a bit of a cheap hit. You saw Nathan with a bit of stick work back in his direction. And those two would be a feisty meet. There's a bit of a
big hit,
pushing and shoving. Sisters comes in. Watt's there. Zajac's there. And Watt's having a bit of a chirp in Zajac's direction. The linesman steps into the play. And at the end of the second.
Yeah, Scissors took a big hit there. And he's looking at the linesman now. The linesman asked him if he's okay. So somebody must have seen him. As you say, right, Watt is checking that he's okay as well. Maybe it'll carry over into the third with a bit of excitement.
So at the end of the second period, we're on the Telford Tigers 2, Hull Pirates 2. The Telford Tigers started that period much better than they started the first. They seemed much more confident, had much more puck control. 7 minutes into it, Jason Silverthorne put the second goal on the clock, which kept them in the lead right up until the dying seconds of that period, where the Hull Pirates threw everything at the net and managed to get a goal with just 42 seconds left in the period. And that's brought it back to evens, Alan.
That's going to lift the Hull Pirates up no end. You know, Telford, in my opinion, dominated 90% of that period. What they were failing to do was put the puck in the back of the net. Brilliant training plays they were doing. It was textbook stuff, failing to finish. And that's cost them dearly at the end there, where Hull have tried the same thing. The last 45 seconds, as you say, they've set it up as they wanted it, and Salem's put the puck in the back of the net. 2-2.
As the game's gone, it's been mirrored. The Tigers were Hull were first to score.
Yep.
Telford equalised. Telford were first to score in the second period, then Hull equalised. So what'll happen in the third? Join us after the break when we'll have more ice hockey action from the third period. So as we look in onto the ice, referee Brooks goes to the centre circle, checks in with the goal judges as he drops the puck on the third period between the Telford Tigers and the Hull Pirates. Both 2 goals apiece going into the third period action here at the Telford Ice Rink. Silverthorne wins the draw, wins straight back to Zajac. D to D pass to Weaver. Headmans to Plant, drives up the left wing. Kalina just behind him. Drives around the back of the net, and there seems to be a certain bit more spark in the Tigers' foot movement in this first couple of seconds.
Well, we see that at the start of third period when the Tigers haven't been playing so well. They're very responsive to Tom's demands, and we've got to hope for their sake that they get something out of this.
Davis picks up the puck. And he's carrying it back, but don't forget, as we watch it, Telford are actually going right to left. Davis pushes down, passes the puck in front, Clarkson comes in and gets a tip on it and fires it back of the net. That's the goal we've been looking for. The work created by Davis, literally skating back into his own end, curled upon the glass, drove it deep into the corner, waits for Clarkson to position himself in the slot, puts the pass across, and Doug Clarkson straight on the end of it to fire it home for goal number 3 for the Telford Tigers. So it certainly didn't take the Tigers long to answer the goals from earlier. 3-2, 1 minute 40 seconds into the third period. So time on the clock, 41 minutes and 40 seconds. Time of the goal from Doug Clarkson.
Doug, he's getting some goals against his name now. He's putting them away. So whatever Tom Watkins said, well, it's paid dividends in that first couple of minutes of that shift. As the Tigers, Adam Taylor goes round the back of the net, forechecking hard.
Played off the boards there by Lane.
Seymour picks it up.
This
here's an up. Oh!
That'll get a cheer and a half as Chilcott loses his footing. He's teeing himself up for a shot. Turned from forwards to backwards. As he pivoted, his blade just caught the eye. So easy to do on a pivot. Falls onto his bottom. The crowd are somewhat impressed, should they say, the Telford fans, of that. And you saw him go with a smile on his face. There was nothing he could do about it. And all in very good faith.
And now
Silverthorne's on the break. Kirk's chasing after him.
Silverthorne
back at it in! And over the net binder and celebrates as he jumps him into the glass. He got the breakaway. Kurt was in hot pursuit, but not quick enough to catch Silverthorne. He drives in on the netminder, pulls it to his left, backhands it over his leg pad, and finds it mid to top shelf in the net, putting Telford 4-2, Alan.
Well, dare we say it, another short-handed goal for the Telford Tigers. And I just said during that breakaway, you've got to fancy Silverthorne on a one-on-one, and he just proved me absolutely right.
Absolutely. 45 minutes and 21 seconds the time of the goal. And we've seen this happen time and time again, haven't we? Tied first period, tied second period, and then Telford get a bit of a motivational speech from Mr. Watkins, and suddenly they come out all guns blazing, are already crocking up two goals in the first 5 minutes, 21 seconds of this game.
Well, that's what we've seen, absolutely. I said at the start, Tom didn't have a very pleasant face on him, and he's done something that's motivated these guys. Long way to go yet, Paul. 4-2.
And that's going to go for tripping against Jones. Haywood steps inside. Taylor gets the puck, passes forward to Silverthorne. Silverthorne and Cahorn. Cahorn gets the pass, comes back to Silverthorne. Deflects from the whole stick into the corner. Silverthorne gains it back. Cahorn picks it up to the point. Rose lets the shot go, takes a deflection from Bonner's skate into the corner. Hull trying to clear it up the wall, but once again, the determination this time of Rick Plant to get the turnover, and Cahorn pokes at the puck to send it back into Hull's defensive end. Chilcott tips it forward now. Silverthorne winds up, shoots and scores! What a wrist shot! Jason Silverthorne picking up the puck, lining it up. What speed that puck was delivered with a rocket of a shot to beat the netminder into the back of the net for the fifth goal of the night. And suddenly the Telford Tigers, 8 minutes and 43 seconds into the third period, have clocked up three goals this period alone. 5-2 the scoreline. Time of the goal, 48 minutes and 45 seconds.
Well, Silverthorne using that pinpoint accuracy of his to pick that was a very acute angle. It was a sort of Clarkson shooting area for me, say so. And he picked that spot and he put the puck where he wanted it.
It wasn't flat either. The puck was bobbling around as it sort of he gained possession, and he just let that shot go with such speed. 5-2 the scoreline. 48 minutes, 45 seconds played here at the Telford Ice Rink.
The captain leading by example there. Two goals tonight, two goals for Clarkson, one for Cahorn. Kalina, we haven't seen, he was running away with some goals. He hasn't been putting it away for the last couple of games.
Plant,
it doesn't matter.
Turns the puck over in neutral ice, and suddenly Telford much more confident on the puck. Yeah. The passes are much cleaner. Good work from Tate to keep the puck down low. Danny Rose looks for a pass. There's nothing there. Watt picks up the puck. Delays it off. Scissors. Curls, twists, changes. Gent receives the pass. Sends the puck around the boards. Danny Rose picks it up. Telford take a line change. Rose is first on the puck. Two Hull players in hot pursuit. Gent skates hard behind the net now, but it's picked up by Oakford. Puts it through to the far side. Goes through to the middle. Backhanded back. Kurt looks for the pass through to Osmond. Looks to come down the middle lane. Jones holds him up, twists him, loses footing. The rebound comes in and he's shot by Tamar and straight into the body of Baston.
Looking a big uphill struggle now for Hull. 5-2. We're what, 2 minutes 48 seconds left.
Now, cross ice pass.
Zajac
carries the puck behind the net, steps out. Curls once again, sets up that breakout. Taylor starts driving up the left wing. Cahorn drives the right, cuts through into the middle lane. Zajac passes in the puck, he picks it up. K
carries on driving forward, beats two defencemen, tries to get it to Tate. There's a reach for the puck, and it was shot from Adam Taylor, I think it was. Great play there between Cahorn, Tate and Taylor. I think it was Taylor was the last man to connect with the puck and fire it back home for the sixth goal of the night. The Telford Tigers getting themselves back on the clock on 57 minutes and 39 seconds, taking the lead up to four goals at 6-2. And so many times this season, Alan, we've seen Tigers run away in that third period as they find their rhythm, as they find their stride. They're nailing the coffins into the opposition teams.
Well, I'd love to know what Tom said before. I'd love to know what Tom was saying there. Yeah. But whatever it was he said, it's worked.
There's been a marked difference between the performance we saw from the Tigers in the first and second period and this school of goals from the third period. 6-2 the scoreline at the Telford Ice Rink. Silverthorne finishes the hit on Stokes. Zajac back at it now. Will Hull get frustrated by this and lash out?
No,
Silverthorne.
They don't want to do
Kalina. Kalina across to Silverthorne, reaches for it. It just runs on a tad too far, and there comes a hit and a half. Goodison puts it across between Oakford and Davis. It ends up down the rink. 26 seconds is what remains on the clock.
And Brody Jessen coming
Jessen's
on for the
back out there
the
again.
Game.
Cross come back, comes cross eyes. Osman tailed out by Goodison.
Well, that's relentless from Hull. They just have not
Jessen
given up.
Jessen picks up the puck, drives it down the left side, holds up without it. Oakford, Davis, Jessen, Taylor, and at the end of the game, we finish the Telford Tigers 6, the Hull Pirates 2 at the end of the game here at the Telford Ice Rink.
So, a good result in the end. First couple of periods took a while to get going.
Yeah, similar to the last couple of performances. I thought we were, energy-wise, we were okay. We really struggled with the puck on our stick. We made a lot of uncharacteristic kind of giveaways, plays, etc. I thought we settled down a little bit in the second. I thought we were way the better, stronger team in the second period, but still we managed to give a couple sloppy opportunities away. But you know what? The third period, as it's been in the last few games, has been really strong for us, but we've got to come out the blocks a little bit harder and be ready to play.
Absolutely. So going forward, of course, midweek game this weekend, just one game on the road next week, and there's a few holes in the schedule now with that Manchester. How do you feel about that?
Like you say, it's disappointing. We want to be playing, but we get a breather on Sunday, which would be nice for the guys to have a day at home on the weekend with their families. But two big points up for grabs in Guildford on Saturday. You know, I think we go down there, we're going to have to play smart, and it's a tough place to play. We've got a lot to play for, so there's no reason for us to be having these bad starts, etc. But you know what? Teams are not going to roll over for us. We've got to come out and we've got to outwork them. And I think through the third period, certainly tonight, we did that.
So a great result for the Telford Tigers, winning 6-2 against the Hull Pirates. Join us next Wednesday when we'll have the Telford Tigers action against the Peterborough Phantoms. Wednesday night, 7 o'clock on Icing Tonight on Made in Birmingham. Silverthorne off the boards, gets the break, goes with it. Silverthorne puts it onto the back post.
Zajac
puts it into the back post, and it goes forward from Macaulay Hayward, having the right hand over the top, driving it in, and Miller's going toe to toe, and he's got three or four headshots, and it drags him down.
Still has it. Darbo being sort of marked out the game by Tom,
and the shot comes from Jones
forward now. Bebrea with plants. Bebrea walks in, shoots.
And he looked up his own rebound and scores.
Zabo, and he's not happy about that. It was a late hit to hit from behind. And you see the players